By default, all S3 resources, that is buckets, objects, and related sub-resources, for example, lifecycle configuration, website configuration, etc., are owned by the resource owner. Resource owner is the AWS account who created all those objects or all those buckets. Resource owner can optionally grant access permissions to others by writing an access policy. There are two ways to control access to buckets and objects: access control lists and bucket or user policies. We'll come back to policies once I cover identity and access management. If I talk about it now, it'll not make much sense. Let's see how ACLs are enabled using Management Console. We have been using ACL to modify permissions ever since we started creating buckets and objects for our demos. Go to the bucket, click on permissions, and here the way you manage permissions is using ACL. So this is ACL we are using to manage permissions to this bucket. So you can give public access or you can give access to other accounts. We have already seen this. Whenever we have been using this option or this screen to grant access to this bucket, we have been using access control lists or ACLs. For the case of objects, whenever we have used this screen to grant access to this object or to any objects for that matter, we have used or we have been using ACLs. Behind the scenes, this ACL is actually an XML document. Let's not go into that detail. So using console, whenever you set up permissions, you are essentially using ACLs. You can also choose encryption to protect your data. Encryption can be enabled for data in transit and data at rest. So server-side encryption provides data at rest encryption, which encrypts data at object level before writing that data to disks in S3 data centers. This is the request header, which is used to pass the encryption information. Server-side encryption can be achieved in various ways. One of them is server-side encryption with S3 managed keys. Each object is encrypted with a unique key. So S3 server-side encryption uses 256-bit advanced encryption standard, or AES-256, to encrypt data. The second option is to use KMS managed keys. This is similar to server-side encryption using S3, but with some additional benefits and charges. There are separate permissions for the use of data encryption key, or DEK. Finally, you can use customer managed keys also. Here, customer manages the encryption keys and S3 manages the encryption. Second option is client-side encryption, which means encrypting data before sending it to S3. The first option is you can use AWS KMS Managed Customer Master Key, wherein KMS can be used to encrypt data at client-side and then send it to S3. Or the second option is client-side master key, wherein client uses its own key to encrypt data and send it across to S3. Something like this. Here's S3 and this is AWS data centers where S3 stores your data. In server-side encryption, data is encrypted at server end and stored in the data center. In client-side encryption, data is encrypted first and sent over to S3. So S3 stores this data to the data center. We'll use KMS to encrypt data which are stored in S3. For that, first of all, we'll need a CMK or customer master key. Go to IMS console and click on encryption keys and then click on create key. Give it a proper name. Keep KMS as the key material origin. The key has been created. We'll use this key to provide server-side encryption facilities in S3. Copy the key ARN. Go to the bucket for which you want to enable encryption. Click on Properties and then click on Default Encryption. Here, either you can use AES-256. If you are using AES-256, you are essentially enabling server-side encryption with S3 managed keys. If you use AWS KMS, then you are enabling server-side encryption with KMS managed keys. We'll have to select a key AWSF and S3 is the default key. Either you can use this default key or mention a custom key. So you'll mention custom key which you have just created and provide the key ARN. Click on save and all my objects in this bucket will be encrypted now onwards. This is how you enable encryption in an S3 bucket. Same can be done at object level also. Go to the particular object, click on properties and then click on encryption. The ways are similar. If you are using AES-256, that means you are enabling server-side encryption using S3 managed keys. If you mention AWS KMS, you'll have to mention either the default key or a custom key ARN. The key should be different for each object. Click on AWS S3 and then click on save. Now this object is being encrypted using server-side encryption KS3 managed keys.